The family I'd like to talk to you about is the Kelroy family, and they have given me permission to talk to you about their situation. They had a child who had gone to the university, and while he was there, he got sick, and he had to go to the hospital. While he was in the hospital, they called the parents up, and they asked him, does this child have a health care power of attorney? Which they were able to answer yes. And they were shocked that he had a health care power of attorney. And so the nurse and doctor asked them, well, how is it that this 20-year-old child has a health care power of attorney? And she told him the story of this attorney, Tim Crawford, myself, who came to church one Sunday and gave the homily. Instead of the minister doing it, I gave it, and we did it on what is a health care power of attorney and why is it that you need one. And we gave them forms to take home to their neighbors, get them signed up, and that family had a health care power of attorney for mom, for dad, and for the two kids. And it's a result of that, having that health care power of attorney, that it gave mom the ability and the authority to make health care decisions for her adult child. And the end result was written in a book called The Year of the Zebra, and talking to the world about what is the situation like when you have a child that needs health care decisions. The good news was she was able to make the decisions for her son. The bad news was eventually he passed on. The most important thing for people when they're planning for the future is to seek good, competent advice. And that usually means they have to go to a specialist. A very difficult thing for children is to how do you talk to your parents about the issue of aging, their needs, their legal needs, their social needs. And it's very, very difficult for children to broach this with their parents. The parents still look at their 60-year-old child as a child. And it's hard for that 60-year-old child to be talking to their 80 or 90-year-old parent about, mom, dad, it's time for you to do some planning. It's so very important. And I like to say this, even if you're not in their hometown, even if you're in California or New York, call them. Watch a TV program that might have the issue being presented in it, and use that to say, hey, Dad, did you see this program? And talk to him about it. It opens it up. And then from there, you can broach the subject of, we need you to do planning. Dad, this will make you feel better if you get it done. You'll have peace of mind. We know that you haven't even done a will yet, or you've done a will and you think you have all your planning done, but maybe you need a trust to make things run smooth at death. Dad, I'm sure you don't want to leave me with a year of work just because you die with a will. Maybe you should have a trust. Maybe we should go and set up an appointment with the attorney. Matter of fact, I was nice enough to do that for you, and we have an appointment set up for Tuesday at 2 o'clock to go see Attorney Tim Crawford to talk to him about what your needs are. And he is a nice, good-looking Irish attorney. You'll be very, very happy to meet with him. In fact, he has a video that I'll be sending to you so you can see him ahead of time.